Hi, welcome back to my garage. Today I'm going to be turning some sheet metal into part of an expansion pipe. I'm not a professional welder, I'm not a professional sheet metal worker. About 15 years ago I started to make two-stroke pipes, just self-taught and stuff that I picked up on the forums. So today I'm just going to show you how I go about it. If you've got any points, any better ideas, better ways of doing it, let us know in the comments. And so off we go. Cheers. So I've got all my bits. These are the original templates I used to make the pipe. I went for an AM6 and I used to have a motor that worked. I can't get it to work on my new laptop, but I used to use this as a good layout and I can work out which sections, what bends I need. However, that was to fit an Aprilia RS50 when I did it for the article. I broke it down so I can see header 1, header 2, both were split up into sections so I could put and bend into them. So I'll make them out of other sections. I'll do it the same so it should still fit the bike. So it's what I'm going to concentrate on. I've got all the bits basically to make this back bit and the sliding bit. I can't remember if I had section 7 with a bend, but we shall find out. So I'm kind of going to build it backwards, but I'm quite happy because it fitted last time, so it'll fit again because I've got all the dimensions. I just may have to make some more cutouts to do because I don't appear to have them with me. So you can see I've just laid these out roughly. One thing, I'm quite lucky there, I think that's looked in, but any straight edge I've got on the material, I'll start a blank from there because it saves me having to cut that bit. Because it is very key to get these bits nice and straight. Okay, just use a pritt stick just to lightly hold it down. I don't put loads on, just a bit around the edges. So that's that stuck down. Then just take a pen and you kind of button up against it so you almost, you can go over the top. And what you should get left behind . Okay, that's there. I'm just going to use a little blade just to get under there. Peel it off. Next, I've got some new snips. I treated myself with some left and right-handed tin snips. So I've always used just a plain set. So I'm going to cut this blank out with a little bit extra. Yeah, they make quite a bit of a difference actually. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is cut to that line. It's always try not to get good light, and I play along with the light. I'll stand a certain direction and I'm cutting to the right, to the edge of that line there. Not very easy to do on camera because I'm trying to look what I'm doing and do it. Let's try. Yeah, not too bad. Not perfect, I've not done it for a few years, so hopefully I'll get my eye back in. Okay, what do you do next to the blank? I try and get it as square as I can. So that's not, I'll just use a pair of pliers. Just tweak that a little bit. I'm now gonna make sure that edge is flat. I do it using just a straight edge, as you can see. And they generally are up a bit here. This is the cut from the material, as you can see, it's spot on. So I'm just going to run a file and I do it in the vise, nice and low, but not too low so I can't get to it. Try and get it square. Got this file, I've had it for years, it's good. I can see, and I am just touching on that, trying to keep it, because it's thick, it's rigid, so it doesn't flex too much. And is what I'm looking for. I'm just going to bring you in. I don't know how well you'll see it, but you can see it's starting to catch. It's starting to fold down a bit. So I'm always looking at this to tell me how, when I've actually filed it flat. So when it's flat, all this will be uniform and I'll see the markings on it. And I'm going to just keep doing that until I get it somewhere in here.
Yeah, I'm happy with that. So it's what I've done. It's really difficult to stop that rocking. So it's what I did in the end. I noticed that it had gone low here and here. So I localized by doing some draw filing and then checking with a ruler. It's a rule, isn't it? This is the last section of the baffle cone, and it's where it goes to where the stinger attachment goes. And this is too small to be rolled by my roller. Because it's going to be difficult getting in there, I try and give it a good, just to clean off, because this is where I'm going to be welding. That's that cleaned up, and now I'm going to form this into a section. Could be interesting. Okay, to do this one, first of all, I'm just going to bit of a bend on it. I do that for all the blanks anyway, but it's probably going to help. And then I'm literally just going to hand form this now. I've not done this for a while, so I'm not sure how well it's going to. It actually doesn't feel too bad metal, this. I got it off eBay, and it doesn't feel like it's going to be a bastard, which is good. That makes me happy. So it's somewhere there. As you can see there now, now the two bits are together. That's why you spend the time filing that nice and flat, because that will weld pretty good. So first cone formed. Okay, a slip roll. I've had this for some years. So you set the distance between these two rollers and that feeds it in, and then you start bending it up by turning these knobs, which pushes this third roller up. So I've marked this up as well, just to give me a reference that these should be, that should be roughly parallel. And again, I've done it on here, which just aids when you're trying to keep track of how many turns you're putting on and are you doing it equally. So I'm just gonna pop some gloves on whilst I cut my hands off. Already cut myself already, look. And we'll go. You notice as I'm going through, I am just putting enough pressure on just to try and keep this so it's staying straight, whereas if you just let it go through on its own, it'd go through like that, and obviously you'd end up with a really curly bit there. So you have got to slip it as you take it through. Keep the two tops level. There's a link video where I learned some top tips from. I'll leave that in the description. Right, start to get a bit tighter now. And you can see I'm backing and forward sometimes just to get it straightened up. I'm putting some force here, but I've got to be careful. Every time I do that, or push here, I'm actually twisting it back out of shape. So it's quite a difficult thing to do. You see it's staying reasonably flat at the minute, so it's starting to come together. I put a lot less turn on as well, so I'll start off with quite coarse, and then as you start to get closer and closer, it soon goes, it just suddenly goes from being miles off to all of a sudden off it is, and then you have to start unwinding it. So there we go, a bit of manipulation. I can easily hold that together, probably a little clamp, get some tacks on that, I'll be quite happy with that. Right, I'll crack on with some more. Okay, as you can see, selection of sections rolled, ready for welding. So the next operation is to weld these. I tend to start off tacking, probably on this 3, maybe 5 tacks. And then once I'm happy, I'll probably give it a bit of a knock, just to, if there's any misalignment. Sometimes you can, if you're careful, it shouldn't be, but if there's any misalignment, you want to get it perfectly flat. So these two bits meet up like that. Obviously, I spent plenty of time getting that square, and as you can see, when I push that together, that's a pretty good fit, meaning I won't need any filler. To hold it in place, you see this is springing apart a bit. There's a couple of ways. I can use these. These are quite good. Get them set right. See, that will hold it. And I can use a pair on each end. This is quite tight, so you see it's starting to pull apart. So what I may do, we could potentially hold it here, get a tack on there, and then you can reapply. The way to get that shut is Jubilee clamps. I've got a selection of, this is quite good, you cut your own size, and it's got a quick release fastener, so that can go around there. As you tighten it up, you're just trying to keep it all nicely aligned. So what you can do is, you can see this keeps moving down, so you just put a clamp there and then adjust that. So I've got two slightly different lengths. I'll have a look at that. I reckon that bit's high. I reckon it wants to be like that. Then use one of these here, so that'll stop it moving, and I can clamp that up. Okay, so I've been to the welder, it's now shut up. I put a little tack there. I've now put a smaller clamp on there. You see it's a little bit sticking up. I'm not too worried about that, because I can feel that that's fairly flush. So I'm going to stick a tack there, and I'll probably put one there before taking it over and hammering it to get that flat. Okay, I've got a few tacks on there now. As you can see, it's not perfectly round or flat, so I'm just going to hammer that out. It's all kind of flat now, so I'm going to put a weld down there. Then I can tweak this to get it a bit more circular. It's not too bad, that end. Okay, off camera, I'll just give that a quick weld. I had it held like that, and then it allows me just to come along with the torch. Because that's held there, I can use two hands. And as I'm going, I just do a little bit of a swirly action. And I do that when I'm tacking as well. I'll accentuate it when I'm doing the tacks. I'm like that, because I'm trying to evenly heat both sides. It's very easy to go through. I'll try to put a bit of heat into everything till I can see it starting to pull. And then I can increase the amps a little bit, and it makes a nice little weld. You're always watching, because you're just waiting for it to go. As soon as it goes into a hole, it's very difficult to start filling. But that's my second go after about 4 or 5 years. So a bit more practice. It's not too bad. It looks okay from the inside. Certainly not round. So I'm going to go sort that out now. Okay, so I'm out there at the minute. It's fairly round now. I've had it in the slip rolls, and I just like to finish off. You can just find, you can just tweak it, just massaging it and making it worse normally. Just a little bit more there. I could faff around with that forever, but it's okay. This is the bit that the diffuser section is going to connect onto. So it's what I'm going to do, because I want a really nice sliding fit in here. As you can see, I've got a little bit of excess, so I can see there I've got probably 2 mil. So I'm going to trim this down with the tin snips now, clamp that up, and I'm just going to scribe a line down there. Right, so focus, we're all welded up. That's that in there. Quite a nice snug fit. generally it seals up quite well. Case my rather sketchy gash cone sanding device. Just a piece of aluminium plate I'll put a bolt through, sanding pad. It sits in there. I probably should get a proper thing, but so what I like about this is I can set it quite low speed, which makes it quite controllable. So if you'll focus, yeah, I'll just keep going until this, I get a nice ring round here. You've got to be careful though, because I like to tweak, and every time I tweak, if as I squeeze that, I'm bringing this up. So if I get it flat, then I squidge it to fit, it's going to bring it out of flatness. So it's a bit of a game. I'm going to have to play with that, which means when I move that, it's going to change the flatness, so you constantly after it. But yeah, all fun and games. So that's where we're at. Little focus. They all sit on top of one another. It's not perfect yet, there's a few gaps, but I might need a little bit of filler wire there, else I'll end up taking too much out. But I'll knock it over. Oh, well, there you go. Anyway, that gives you an idea. So I've been going for about half an hour or so, just flipping back and forth, getting the fits. Alright, stacked up, ready to go. Got plenty of tungsten ready. Top tip, grind them all up before you start, because you do tend to dip them. And where I was shown a while ago, grind your tungsten, you stick it in your drill on the slow speed, and then just put it on the grinding wheel there, that way, and the grinding wheel comes across. Additionally, it's what I've done. I've been through and I've verified. It's a bit tricky on, but I've actually used the eye-chrometer to check that over at 90, and I can go through and just verify the lengths of these as I've got them all written down. Okay, that's the first few welds. I actually did four in the end. I wasn't happy with it. It's not too bad. You can see my fitment's not perfect. I don't think I've ever had it absolutely perfect. That could have maybe gone a bit further that way. That could have gone a bit further that way. And that's just the variation in diameters. However, it's nice and tight there. And then as I weld round it, it will blend in okay, and it'll be fine on the inside. And also you can see this next section is still fitting quite nice. It's a good fit up, so I'm not too worried about that. Art, I like to think so. I do think it's a beautiful looking thing. So I've been through, I've put some additional tacks on, so I'm going to be able to hammer the metal a little bit prior to final welding once it's all together. So that's that done. What have I got left? I've got to chippy chop some paper so I can figure out, make sure the header fits. I need to make a manifold as well, so that'll be back to the lathe, and a boss for the EGT probe to go in the header, and the stinger section as well. So that'll be to come up in the next installment once I've had time to make it. So any comments, any points, let us know. Catch you next time. Cheers for watching. I was your